Learning today, students, the difference between a herb, shrub and tree. So ma'am is going to show you a variety of herb, shrub and tree so that you can understand the difference in a better manner. So here you have got this spider plant, which has got these wonderful variegated green leaves with white stripes on the sides, and you can see it has got no branches, only the leaves are there. So naturally you can say that it is a herb. This is a small aloe vera plant, which is actually a succulent. You can call it as a herb with no branches it is. This is a tradescantia, and it is also having a single branch, a single stem you can say. So it's also a herb. Then there are some more plants which are actually herbs. Like you can see, this is also a herb. But we have got the plant of tulsi. Tulsi plant is a shrub because it is having the hard, thick, woody stem, and the branching of the plant starts from the bottom itself. So it's a shrub. These vegetable plants, that is your lady's finger, is a herb because it is having tender green stem and no branching, only leaves are getting separated. So it will be a herb. Their height also doesn't grow much. It is a herb plant. This is the banana plant, which is the biggest herb. As you can see, the stem is green in color. There is no branching. Only leaves are there on the top. It has very big leaves and it grows up to a big height. This stem is also green in color. And it is a herb. It's one of the biggest herb. This hibiscus plant is a shrub. As you can see, the stem is hardy, thick, and branching has started from the bottom of the plant of hibiscus. Same way, this coleus, which looks so wonderful, is a shrub. Its branching has also started from the bottom. And the main stem is thicky, woody and hard. So these two are shrubs, that is coleus and this hibiscus plant. It is a shrub. Now of India, let's check it is what type of a plant. So see children, these branches of the plant, from where it's coming, the branches of the plant have started from the bottom itself. And this main stem is thick, woody and hardy. So I think you have understood what type of a plant it is. It is a, yes, you are right, it is a shrub. Now let's see this. This is your hibiscus plant. Hibiscus plant is having thick and woody main stem, and branching has started from here. This is the base and it has started from here. So you can tell, I think, now by now, yes, it is also a shrub. Then I'll show you one more plant. This is your coleus. Coleus appears so beautiful with its wonderful leaves, and these are the flowers of coleus which have come up. And let's see the branches of this coleus plant. See from where the branches are coming. Here the base, and then this is the branch which has started from here, and the main stem is there. This is the main stem, and the main stem is very thick, woody and hardy. So it is also a shrub. This lemon plant also, the main stem is hard and woody. So it's an example of a shrub. This is a tree of a guava, and you can see why we call it as a tree. The branching of the guava plant, a tree, it starts from the top. The trunk is very thick. You can see the trunk is very thick and brown in color. And if I try to press it, nothing happens with it. And the branching is starting from top. So it is a tree. Guava is a tree. You can see the trees. Like this is a variety of neem. And it has grown up so big Its height is so big and the branching has started from the top of the trunk only. Similarly, there are so many other trees you can see here in the surroundings, and all of them have got their branching from top of the tree. Like this is a neem tree in which the branching has occurred from the top of the trunk only. So we can learn about such wonderful things. You can see the comparison between a herb and a tree also here. You have a banana and a neem tree standing nearby. So I hope you can understand easily the difference between them. That is a banana and a neem tree. Banana is having green stem and which goes straight, while a tree is having a thick trunk which is brown, generally brown in color, and branching starts on the top of a neem tree, while banana plant does not have any branching. So banana is the biggest herb, so its height will grow up to this level. These jade plants, which are so small, actually they are also shrubs. Even though their branch is not very hard, but it's brown in color as you can see, and the branching has started from the bottom of the plant, so it is also a shrub. Shrubs can be small also, small in height also. It's not necessary that it will be up to our height, but main thing is its stem would be woody and it would be brown in color, and the branching will start from the bottom of the plant itself, as you can see in this jade plant. The plant of a tulsi, in which this stem is very thick and brown in color and the branching has started from the bottom. So this is a shrub plant and it is very very clear example of shrub. So even though when it is very small, the plant is green in color, as you can see here, the plant is green in color, but as it grows, the main stem becomes hard and woody and it is very thick. So it is a shrub. This red rose plant is a shrub, because here also you can see the stem is very thick and hardy, and the branching has started from the bottom of the plant itself. So it's a shrub. Then we have this aloe vera. It is a herb, but it is a succulent also, storing water in its leaves. Then you have this periwinkle or sadabahar, which has got purple and white flowers. You can see this plant here, the main stem is thick and hardy and I cannot bend it, and its branching has started from the bottom of the plant itself, as you can see here. So this is a shrub. See here, this ornamental plant is actually a herb because it does not have any branches. These are big leaves. Well, this one is a jamun tree. So it's, you can see the trunk is so thick. Trunk is so thick and its branches start from the top of the tree only. Top of the trunk, the branches are coming. So you can understand the difference between a tree, a herb, and there is a shrub also here. This is your kari patta, which is used as a spice. Its leaves, you can see the branches have started from the bottom. The main trunk is brown and very thick and hardy, and the branching has started from the bottom itself. This is kari patta, which is a shrub, and this is a jamun tree, which is a tree, while this is a ornamental plant with flowers on it, and it is a herb. This is a lemon plant, and lemon plant, you can see the branches are very thick, woody and hard, and they are brown in color, and its branching, as you can see in this case, the branching has started from the bottom itself. So it's a shrub plant, but when you handle such plants, you should be very careful because they have thorns on them. So if you touch it, you can get the thorns on your hands. So be very careful while handling such plants. So I hope it's clear to you that what is a shrub and what is a tree. As I've shown you, the tree of guava here, and there is shrub of this lemon here, and you can see nearby I have got the herb of this is the plant of lady's finger. So it's green and there are no branching in this. So by comparing these three plants which are nearby, you can understand what is a shrub. That is, lemon is a shrub. This lady's finger is a herb with no branching and with tender green stem. And this thick trunked, your guava tree is there. So with their stems itself, you can understand the difference between these three type of plants. So I hope the difference between a shrub, a herb and a tree is very, very clear to you by this video. So hope all of you have subscribed to your own channel, that is Unique Learning, and you are getting lots of benefit by seeing all the wonderful videos from this channel. So stay tuned to this channel and daily visit the channel. You can like the videos, share it with your friends, and don't forget to give your wonderful remarks, as ma'am will provide you all the wonderful videos with all good health benefits and all the nice videos about nature, science, environment and many more such wonderful things. Happy learning. Thank you.